are you looking at, what the number?
The FARS manual, speech number two.
Number two, from the first manual, speech number two. And the title of Harry, speech is, "The storm is over now," or is it? Because effects on life and things we cannot control. Let's welcome Christina Arnold.
Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and armored guests, there's no way to sugarcoat it. Hurricane Irma is a catastrophic storm and is headed towards Florida and potentially the southeast coast. If it makes landfall in Florida, it will be the first hurricane to do so since Wilma in 2005. The effects could be so devastating for the population that it has ballooned in recent decades. Because of the potential impact, Florida and southeast residents should be executing their emergency plans now. Even if the storm doesn't make a direct landfall, the region is still at risk for severe impacts. Wind gusts could exceed 100 miles per hour. This is Christina Arnold reporting live from Fox 35 News. So what comes to mind when you hear the names Katrina, Harvey, Matthew, Irma, Jose, and Maria? So initially the first thing that ran through my mind is that I never want a storm to be named after me. Well, we know that these are storms that made a significant impact on millions, whether it caused physical or mental damage on anyone. Most of us have grown up or lived in Florida for the majority of our lives, and we know that this is a peninsula state, and a lot of times we have become desensitized to what the media says when it comes to tropical storms, tornadoes, and hurricanes. And unfortunately, we become numb and complacent because we hear it over and over again of preparation tools and things of this sort, especially when we know that the weatherman reports sometimes tend to fluctuate more than the stock market. So, to keep it 100 with you, I really was not taking things that serious until my work shut down. That's when things got real, raw, and ungood. Most people that know me personally know that I am a Sam's Club addict. It's really bad. And so I told people all the time if the storm was going to hit and I was to die, it would not be of starvation. Maybe because I can't swim. So the items that I already usually have in my house are food and toiletries and other pertinent items, but the OCD in me would not let me be still. So I stayed in and out of Walmart and Home Depot and Sam's Club, back and forth and back, getting items that were pertinent for my home, my children, and people around me. So as the storm got closer, most people's nerves just increased to the 10th power. I noticed that Sam's Club opened their store to the public, not requiring a Sam's Club membership, and that's when things kind of got out of hand. In the wee hours of the morning, I noticed that the line was wrapped around the building. But as soon as they opened up the door, people rushed in skipping, forgetting that there was order and decency. The police had to be called because you're talking about grown people acting a fool trying to get the last few cases of water. I believe a few days before they had it initially to where each customer could get 5 cases of water. Then it went down to 2 cases of water per customer. We already know that gas prices were insane and they still are. People were trying to fill up their vehicles, RVs, and gas cans and things of that sort. And people that know me, I drive a, my blue is called Big Blue, and it's a Suburban. So you can only imagine the arm, leg, and the thigh that I had to put in my gas tank because I was really in my feelings. So we know that the city or the county opened wide in different locations to prepare sandbags. And I've never worked so hard in my life. I remember going and shoveling, and then you have different elderly people that were out there, so I ended up helping other people. Baby, it felt like a full body workout the next day. But it was real how people came together cohesively to prepare for this storm. I remember going home and seeing my neighbors work diligently to cover the houses with boards and shutters. And I had a flashback remembering last year during Hurricane Matthew when I did all this preparation and covering And nothing happened major to my house but the loss of power for 6 days. And you know that's real when I shop in bulk at Sam's Club and my deep freeze in my refrigerator was lost of all the major essentials because I like to eat, so I was therefore in my feelings. But something came to me and I said, you know what, I'm going to just be still and just roll with the punches. I did not cover anything in my house. But one thing that I did do, my mentor slash play mom told me to anoint my house. So I took some praying oil and I anointed every window and every door. And all is well, thank God. The only thing that really could run through my head because everybody else was covering their house up was my aura. I'm OCD, I'm ADHD, and a couple other diseases. So I was breaking my neck to call Bill, the org man at the Daytona Beach flea market, to say, hey, can you fix my vacuum? Because the only thing that I could think of is, how in the hell would I be able to walk across my floor if the power went out and it was all kind of foolishness on my floor? And I sometimes vacuum, sometimes 3 to 5 times a day. Don't judge me. So I ended up going to my girlfriend's house and I took care of that. I ended up playing Mr. Fix-It and I fixed it myself. My family, friends, and loved ones all pressured me to come to Atlanta, go to Jacksonville where I was born and raised. My play son said, come to Louisiana. He had his mom and grandmother calling me. And something just told me to be still. So I decided to stay, but what I did do, I took a whole chicken and a roast beef and some potatoes and I put it in, utilized the 4 quart pots that I have. Because I said, okay, common sense had to come into play. If I did lose power, then at least I would know that I would have a hot meal that would carry me and the kids over for, if not a few hours, maybe a day or so, it would stay warm if I stayed, kept the crock pot on high. But thank God I did not lose power, only Wi-Fi that only affected my son, who's amongst this new generation at 13, and he about lost his mind. So I had to end up, once the Spectrum old White House people came out days later, I ended up having to make them a pan of brownies. But one thing that really destroyed me was looking at, I talked to a student today and she said that 75% of the Bahamas was destroyed. Then the death toll. I noticed that we did not lose a lot of people in comparison to Katrina and other storms like that, but the improper use of the generator really threw me off. How people didn't, I don't know whether they didn't really have the common sense or knowledge to know if everybody was just so stressed and overwhelmed.
Whoa!
Okay. So I don't know if they didn't know, but they kept the generators. Some people had the generators inside of the home or the garage, which is definitely a no-no. Please don't do that if you own a generator. So everything, as we know, everything in life has a cause and effect. So I was out of work for 8 days, and we know that was like a mini vacation. I wish I was on, you know, somewhere in Australia or some fancy, attractive island that did not get destroyed. But one thing about it is I'm a part-time worker and an adjunct professor, so no work, no pay. Thank God for vacation, though. So gas prices are still high. Stores are trying to still restock. Power and cable companies and tree workers are still working around the clock. But think about it. I give more props and praise right now to the insurance companies because although these other workers are working diligently around the clock right now, insurance companies and claims will still be coming in over the next few weeks, months, and even a year or so. So that's where the real job is going to come in at. And then I saw on the news when people are looting. I said, really? Come on now. So here are a few things that were useful for this storm, and I think will be useful for us for future storms. So I got my handy, I forgot my other props, so don't judge me. The handy dandy Ziploc. And so therefore, when I shop at Sam's Club, I have Ziploc bags on stack, because if you notice, if you're buying meats and supplies that need to be stored in your refrigerator, space is very limited. So I'm always going to have these to break down my meat and put things up. But also, we can utilize these to fill up with water. A lot of people don't think about it. Fill it up with water and freeze these bags. So God forbid how people were running out of ice and water. Here's your water right here. Freeze it. Oh, you want some cube ice for your moscato? Okay, brush it up and keep the party going. Okay? The other piece is taking a clear water bottle, taking a wrapper off of it, taping a flashlight on the bottom of it to turn it into a lantern. Another piece is filling up the bathtub with water. God forbid if sometimes when power goes out, you never know if the water may go out. So how are you going to flush your toilet? Things to make you go home. Air freshener is another essential that I have in my world. The other piece is that something that I did not utilize and didn't even think about is utilizing the dishwasher to store important documents such as birth certificates, social security cards, and other pertinent items. Aluminum pans. And I'm always cooking and preparing things for the homeless, but the aluminum pans could be used to prop up furniture, to take care of furniture and elevate the furniture in your house. Also, the washing machine, I don't know if you heard about, you can store ice and use that as a mini cooler. And last but not least, for this piece, those that have dogs and animals, you can take a kiddie swimming pool and fill it with pieces of sod. Therefore, if we've had curfew acts and things of that sort where people were not allowed to go outside and go places, you don't want your animal outside because a lot of times we treat our animals like our children or humans. So therefore, we can put them in the garage or in the household area with the kiddie pool with the sod inside of it. So once we returned, I had to reach out to my college students and kind of interact with them in terms of doing a survey to ask them about their feelings and their emotions and any damages to their house. And the basics of what I got was the average person spent $300 to $500 on a one-way ticket, is what I noticed. And so then I had another student that said, oh, her mom spent $2,000 on food and other beverages. But the one student that stepped out to me, she said she spent $226.35 because it was her personal money. One thing that I noticed is when it's not your money, people tend not to know. So what I made my students do is I told them to reach out to someone they have disconnected from and always, in life, always remember to remain thoughtful and thankful. Thank you.
Thank you.